Welcome on down to Arcade Appreciation, ladies and gentlemen. Razzle Joestar bringing you Mega Man the Power Battle. This was originally released in Japan, and I actually have seen it a couple places in the US, but I don't think it got that widespread release. But as you can see, it's basically a Mega Man Bus Rush mode. You pick from either Proto Man, Mega Man, or a base, and you pick which selection of robot masters you want to fight, and you blast your way through them. It's pretty straightforward, pretty fun. And let's get started. So as you can see, we got our ever trippy opening screen. You pick from one of these three characters. Given that there's multiple playable characters, you guessed it, round robin style. And for this video, we'll be going through each of the three different courses. Let's start with Mega Man 1 through 2. So stage select. Stage select has a roulette style, so let's just deal with that one. They don't tell you which robot master is on what stage, so of course the only way to learn is to play the game multiple times and memorize it. Looks like we're up against Cutman from Mega Man 1. And they all pretty much attack like they do from their original games. So if you kind of remember how or know how each person attacks, and you pretty much can use that. With the added benefit of the sliding move, which you do down plus jump, and buster shots, because in the original Mega Man, they didn't have sliding nor buster shots. And that was it. Already retired Cutman. And if you're new to Mega Man, for whatever reason, You might not be familiar with the concept of Mega Man, which is every time he beats a boss character, he gets one of their special weapons. One of the general ideas of Mega Man is that each boss is actually weak to another boss's weapon. The trick is figuring out which boss is weak to what. This game is going to be a little bit tricky because they mix the bosses up. Like, this guy was from Mega Man 2, not 1, so his weakness weapon is going to be different than his original game. And you can tell because of that, does more damage than a normal shot. I like how they added those little things there. This guy's Crash Man. As you can see, his thing is throwing those little drill-like things that explode. But I think we've pretty much... Oops! We pretty much got him here. There you go. And then, of course, you use the third button to switch between your different powers. Proper Mega Man games will actually have a pause screen, and then later Mega Man games on like the Super Nintendo and PlayStation added in being able to switch through your special powers with the shoulder buttons. So you don't have to pause the game or use a one button to cycle through all of them. And we got Woodman next from Mega Man 2. I wonder if he's got a wooden sense of... Oh, wow. But, yeah, see, that's not his weakness because we don't get that special flash. Also, why can't I? There we go. Mega Man just got mega owned. A little rolling power always gives me trouble. You can actually knock him out of it if you bust him with a charge shot. Every time I try to predict where he's gonna go, I mess it up. That's funny. There we go. Got him. See, I should've just stayed where I was. Alright, just gotta wait... Gotcha! There we go! Easier said than done. And you actually don't have any lives in this game, so once you die, you have to continue. The only thing I don't like is they don't show you what the power is, so if you haven't played Mega Man 1 or 2, you have no idea what Leaf Shield does. I mean, you probably could guess, but still, it'd be nice. Let's do this one. Looks like we got... It's Gutsman! It's a joke from one of them. It's a moment from the Mega Man cartoon that people make fun of. Oh, there you go. Looks like he's weak to Crash Man. Kind of makes sense. He's a tough construction type robot. So naturally, demolition would be his downfall, but looks like we're in trouble because there's not enough of it to go around. Actually, I don't know if he originally did that rush attack. I know he would throw stuff at you. Alright, Mega, let's see if you got this. Now, the power you get here actually is different from Mega Man 1. In Mega Man 1, you got Super Arm, which lets you actually lift up certain blocks and throw them out of the way to get to secret areas. Now, this one, I think... I forgot what they did. I think you just shoot rocks, or a rock comes down and you throw it or whatever. It's been a while. Iceman! You're a little tiny igloo type guy. Ooh, they're using the Freeze Man song from Mega Man 7. That's actually one of my... Oh yeah, there we go. This seriously shoots a... I like Iceman. Look at him. He's as cute as a... Gotcha. It's actually easier than I remember it. Then again, I'm a little bit better at playing Mega Man games than I was when I was a kid. When I first played this, I was getting owned left and right, but this is before I actually did a proper run-through of all the Mega Man games. I haven't done it on this channel, but I did a thing a few years ago where I went and played all the Mega Man games, 1 through 8. Heat Man, well, I wonder what he's weak to. You look like a Zippo lighter, friend. Actually, you know what? Instead of round robining, why not just use one character for each playthrough? Like, since there's three different... Yeah, I'm gonna do that instead. Sorry, guys. Especially since Mega Man's mega taken up most of the screen time here, so for this round. After this guy, we just got one Wily boss, and then we fight Wily himself. Ooh! We just got owned. There we go. Clear bonus! You got a new weapon! Atomic Fire. Is it gonna be lightning? No lightning? Okay. That's cool. Oh, the Yellow Devil. This guy. Originally appearing in Mega Man 1, and I also realized I neglected to tell... to say which boss came from where. I think the remaining guys we fought were all from Mega Man 1, so... I think only, Woodman and Crash Man were from, Mega Man, were from Mega Man 2. Everybody else was from the first one. Oh, whoa, that's new. Actually, this guy isn't really attacking like he normally attacks. Usually he splits off into chunks and comes at you. Oh, like that. Except there's a lot more... frustrating than that. And he's the first Wily boss you fight in the first Mega Man game, and he's a tough one. And now we come to the Mad Doctor himself. Time to throw down showdown, Wily. Hmm. So this obviously isn't from any of the Mega Man games, at least not that I remember. Oops. Let's try to keep the contingency. Oh, there we go. Now, of course, that's not the end. Oh yeah, I forgot, you gotta hit him before the timer runs out to get a good... Nope. I mean, nothing happens, he still... I think he still blows up and you get him, or... No, okay. Alright. Welcome back, Mega Man. Glad to see you made it. Yeah, but Dr. Wily got away again. Okay, his voice totally doesn't sound... Mega Man, I'm glad you came back in one piece. Even so, if things don't change, the battle against Dr. Wily will never end.
It's just like you say, but this time we learned what robots need.
A hero like me, right?
Oh, you. Well, not quite. What exactly do we robots need?
Like humans, the robot has to determine what is right and what is wrong by itself. Robots are not supposed to hurt humans. We need to research more on an AI program.
When will there be world peace? That's kind of off topic.
That will be off to us.
Okay, I'll fight for everyone's future. So, that's the end of Mega Man's little playthrough. I believe the endings for each character are the same throughout each of the three little, storylines. So, let's go ahead and see if we can skip these little credits here. Oh, there we go. And that's it. So those, for folks not into Mega Man, those characters that we saw there, the girl was Roll, which was a sister robot created by the guy on the right, Dr. Light, who's the good doctor. The guy on the far left, the robot talking about being a hero, is, I think his name is it Otto? Oh shoot, I forgot his name. I think it's Otto, I don't remember, I might be wrong. But he appears in Mega Man 7, and in Mega Man 7 you can collect items called bolts that you can use to purchase upgrades and items between stages, and you go to him to get those upgrades. So, let's go! The general gist of the Mega Man games is that you got the mad doctor, Dr. Wily, who makes these evil robots to try to take over the world, and of course Mega Man and his friends are the ones that go out and try to stop him. The guy on the far right base was actually created by Wily, but he has a bit of an ego complex and likes to prove that he's the strongest, so that's his reason for fighting. Proto Man was actually a prototype robot created by Dr. Light, but he ran away. So he's kind of like... He's kind of like Racer X in the sense that he just appears and helps Mega Man out when he needs it. Except the game doesn't constantly remind us that he's Mega Man's long-lost brother. No, seriously, watch the Speed Racer cartoon, it never shuts up. Every time Racer X appears, Racer X, who is secretly Speed Racer's brother who had ran away from home when he was younger. It's like, God bless the Speed Racer anime. And that was it. That was Gyro Man. I don't remember which one he's from, because this one they do Mega Man 3 through 6. So I don't remember where everyone's from exactly. I'll remember the Mega Man 6 guys, but that's because I played that game a lot when I was younger, so... Okay, this guy I know is from Mega Man 5, Napalm Man. That's when they try to make Proto Man seem like he was actually a bad guy. Of course, there's more to the story than that. So as you can see, there's already some differences between Mega Man and Proto Man that I like. For instance, their blaster shots are different instead of just reusing the same graphics. And then Proto Man actually does his dash differently. He dashes forward with his shield up, which actually doesn't protect you or anything, but it's still nice.
it's cool to see that they didn't just, you know, change and palette swap the character. Oh, they kind of palette swaps, but, like, they came up with different animations for them, I mean. It's a nice little touch. A little goes a long way in my book, anyways. Like, a Proto Man just grins. Oh, also, if you're wondering what that is when he teleports in, that's supposed to be his song. He's supposed to whistle that when he comes in. Magnet Man! I kind of skipped his intro, but... Magnet was from... I want to say... 3? I might be right? Like you see, I'm doing it a little bit harder with these guys, because those first guys from Mega Man 1 through 2, they're a little not as, like... A little bit more simplistic, I guess. And Proto Man just got owned. Proto Man was also in the Mega Man cartoon that came out, that was American produced, by Ruby Spears. And there's a episode where Mega Man acts like he's the bad guy. Dr. Wily, like, brainwashes Mega Man, but then they catch on to what's going on, and they're able to de-brainwash Mega Man. And Mega Man acts like he's still part of Wily's team, and high-fives Magnet Man and takes his powers, and Magnet Man goes, "He's getting my power!" Well, it's hilarious. It's like, high five, Magnet dude. Prump. He's getting my power. Like, it's almost as classic as the over 9,000 moment from Dragon Ball Z. Actually, I think they're the same voice actor. It'd be funny if that was. So Proto Man gets his power and gets Magnet Missile. Gemini Man. I think this guy's 5. There's probably somebody in the comment section being like, "No use for Krug, he's from Mega Man 4. Well, I finally got a weakness weapon. You gonna do anything else? Oh, there he goes. I'm trying to, like, wondering what he's gonna do is... Oh, there he goes. That's his main technique, is it? Splitting himself up at the Gemini laser that ricochets. Got him. There we go. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Let's go to Dinosaur Park. Plant Man! The only Mega Man 6 boss in this game. I think, yeah. It sucks, because I like plant type characters. I like plant type characters. But it sucks, because Mega Man 6 was the one I grew up playing. I even attempted to do a Let's Play of the game on my channel. If you dig far back enough, you'll see it. I really need to finish that sometime, too. Or, like, do over. I don't expect people to remember something I uploaded years ago. So I can see he's kind of like a Woodman in the sense that he's got his little deflector shield that he does. And then he shoots out those little guys, which they're easy enough to defeat. Just hit them when they sprout up, and yeah. Oh, it's Wily Land, not Dinosaur Land. Well, I'm calling it Dinosaur Land because I feel like it. I like that little smirk he does. Alright, last guy is... Dustman. I think he's three, yeah. Or is he four? I don't remember. Like I said, I don't really remember. Oh, but I found a sweet. Okay, can anybody, like, try to explain to me how a leaf shield is a weakness? Like, also, I can see that leaf shield works differently than it does normally. Because in the Mega Man game, in Mega Man 6, when you touch something with the leaf shield, it goes away. Or a plant barrier, whatever. You can also throw it off at them. I'm actually gonna try to... Oops. Whoops! I meant to slide, but I didn't time it right. Alright, Proto. On the positive side, I get my plant barrier. You get new weapon, Dust Crusher. And it's Wily time. So like last time, you fight a boss for taking on the Big W himself. I think they changed the boss for the courses, I'm not sure. Oh no, they don't. Okay, that must have been, and they did a sequel to this one called The Power Fighters, and I believe in that one, they'll actually change what the pre-Wily boss is. I think it's either this guy, or it's... I think there's a couple that switches between. Oh, they do change it. Okay, this is new. I like that. That's an unexpected surprise, and that's always fun. Oh, you can get busy. So I was trying to find a different power to use on them that might whittle them down quicker than, See, this is the problem with Proto Man's little shield slide thing he does, is that he can't slide under things like Mega Man can. Actually, I don't know if Mega can slide under him, but... Oh, you can see the Robot Masters in the background there from other Mega Man games. Wait, is that Napalm Man? Didn't we destroy Napalm Man? Whatever. I'm asking too much. I mean, most Mega Man games, Dr. Wily somehow clones his robots too, so... And, of course, the Wily fight. It's pretty much the same. I believe it's the same as before. That would suck if that was a weakness weapon. I'd be like, really? This weakness is garbage. Ooh! Got him. Out of bullets. Gotcha. Stop it. Stop searching. Oh well, maybe Beast will be able to bag him. Proto Man, who is he? Oh, Proto Man, Dr. Light's first ever built robot just before completion. He ran away and vanished. He appears before Mega Man from time to time and mysteriously disappears. Is he friend or foe? Where is he off to? Nobody knows. Well, I mean, I kind of already told the audience that he was a good guy, so, I mean, kind of a dropped the ball there. Well, I guess they're assuming that, you know, the person, you know, doing this isn't really familiar with Mega Man games or whatever. I don't know. But I got my name put in ASCAP because I just suck at doing that. Alright, so let's go ahead and finish this off with a run of base. So this one we're just fighting all Mega Man 7 bosses. Like Shade Man. Ooh, I actually like Shade Man's music. Also, Bass does this really... One thing I don't like about Bass is he does this really annoying, dash where he does that instead of sliding. There we go. Also, what's up with Bass's character picture? It looks like he's got no sleep. So yeah, as I mentioned before, Bass is kind of like an evil Mega Man created by Wily, but Bass is obsessed with beating Mega Man and proving he's the strongest. He first appeared in Mega Man 7 and later reappears in Mega Man 8. He also was a character you could select with the game Mega Man Bass. Which I don't actually remember the story for that one, I just know that Mega Man and Bass have, like, worked together or whatever. Man, he's just getting me with that. As soon as I dash up there, he gets me with that. There we go. Hits him with that little shot. So as you probably can see, the game isn't really meant to be... I actually don't take the game as being super difficult. The real challenge isn't in completing it, it's getting the best score and getting it done quickly. As you might have seen, there is a time ranking for people who are able to clear through the stages fast, but I don't think you can actually get on that board if you continue. So I think it's people who manage to one credit continue it. Slash Man. Alright, let's see. So obviously, whatever their normal weakness weapon is, here is whatever they're weak to, but I don't... Wait, is he... He's making little Vega sounds from Street Fighter. Vega is a masked fighter that uses a claw arm in the Street Fighter series, and he makes really high-pitched noises when he does anything. He does like a little rolling move and he goes, and other things like that. He's your typical pretty boy narcissistic character. Well, not Slash Man, but ooh, I just got slashed. I like that. That's a fun little reference on Capcom's part. You get new weapons, Slash Claw. Freeze Man. Oh, look, there's Iceman in the background. Okay, also, I don't remember what the weaknesses were for the bosses in Mega Man 7, so... Because I don't play Mega Man 7 that much. I actually have a box copy of that game I got from a friend. Well, I bought it from a friend, but still. It's pretty sweet. Instruction manual and everything. Freeze cracker. Ooh. Alright, Inny Meeny Miny Moe catch a tiger by the toe. Oh, I think this is gonna be Cloud Man. Are you okay there, pal? I'm puffing up quite a bit. Cloud Man's also another one of my favorite, themes from Mega Man 7. Although this is a little bit more easier because there actually isn't a ledge he can push you off of. When you fight him in Mega Man, when you fight him in Mega Man 7, you're actually fighting him on a platform, and you can fall off it. And I think he has an attack that pushes you away towards the edge, I'm not sure, but yeah. Or does he? I think so, yeah. I know Tengu Man and Tengu Man from Mega Man 8 and Storm Eagle from Mega Man X do that. Nope! Come on, base, step your game up. In Mega Man the Power Fighters, they actually added. That's not perfect. I mean, I got perfect, but it's not perfect because I died and restarted, so. I always feel like I'm cheating when that happens. I know, no, it's not my fault, it's the game's design, but. But anyways, yeah, special moves, and Bass does a move where he does a backwards kick, and he shouts Crescent Kick. And I read somewhere online that it was Texas Kick, and I thought that's what he was actually saying. Personally, I like the name Texas Kick better, because it just sounds silly, but. Oh, they didn't use Turbo Man's theme. This is the, intro stage theme from Mega Man 7. So you can see there with Shade Man's ability, you can shoot it, bounce it off a wall, and if you catch it, it gives you a stronger dosage. Of course, it doesn't work while Turbo Man is doing his little transformer thing there. Oh wow, I totally screwed that up. As you say, it crashed and burned. Alright. The game decided to glitch for a second there. Burning wheel. What about burning finger? And, yep, it's Wily time. Let's do it! Oh, hey! Okay, that's new. This guy showed up as a mid-boss in Stage Man. In Shade Man's level. As you can see, Bass's little leaping thing isn't really helping me much. Oh no, actually, yeah, it works. Okay. It's just I gotta be different with the timing. I think Mega Man actually has. Yeah, see, Mega Man would have been able to get around that, I think. Gotcha! Now it's time to get totally owned by Wily. Alright. Do it. Maybe Bass will finally be able to, will be the one to catch him. Are you serious? Really? You had to pick the worst weapon for this boss as a weakness. Not to mention, it didn't really do much. Yes. Actually, I don't have an idea. Alright, I'm gonna try it. I'm just gonna keep hitting him with this, and then. Gotcha! Like how it actually said a win. And that's it, you just get extra bonus, I think, for catching Wily. And then that's Bass's theme playing in the background. No, my laboratory! Bass, what are you doing? Now you know that I am the strongest. There's no need for you to make any more junk robots. The strongest, huh? You've been beaten by Mega Man before. I underestimated him that time, but I will conquer him this time. Yeah, right. You battle with Mega Man all you want. The robot of mine I'm making right now will blow the both of you away. Huh. All you make is junk. Do what you want. Wait, Bass, wait! Don't leave me here! And that was it! That's Mega Man the Power Battle. As you can see, I actually like it because it's really, unlike most Mega Man games, it's really chill. And I say that because if you haven't experienced Mega Man games, buckle up and get ready, because a lot of them are difficult, especially the earlier Mega Man games. They're pretty tough. So if you want to put your gamer skills to the test, look no further than the Mega Man series. But also, because as you noticed, it's not that difficult, and it's like a nice little fun game to just run through. But of course, like I said, the real challenge isn't getting to the end of the game. It's raking up those bonuses for having your vitality up and managing to clear the game so you can get those sweet rankings on the time board. I still like it, though. Alrighty. This time I'm not gonna put my name in as a Capcom. Let's just do RA period, why not? So, that was it! That was Mega Man The Power Battle. My name is Russell Joestar. Make sure to rate, comment, and subscribe for more Arcade Madness, and I will see you all on the next battle. Take care, everybody.